Yeah.
You know, up to 100 hours, yeah. You'll take a shot and we'll give you $100.
Have a beer or have a sausage.
Used to be that if you wanted a shot, you'd find your $5 and pay for it.
Yeah.
You know, but that's not the case. And right now, they're... Hello, everybody, and thank you for tuning in to the Liberty Report. With us today is Daniel McAdams, our co-host. Daniel, good to have you with us today.
Good morning, Dr. Paul. How are you doing?
Doing well, doing well.
Sunny day?
Back at the desk again, trying to sort out all falsehoods and the truths. And it's not the easiest thing in the world. You know, I keep thinking, well, why don't we just call the FBI and maybe they'll help us. Oh, no, we have to investigate them, too. You know?
No good guys.
Well, if we can't trust the FBI, you surely could trust the CIA.
That's right.
And then if you couldn't trust them, how about a congressional investigation set up by Nancy Pelosi? They'll get to the bottom of it, and they're getting to the bottom of this January 6th incident.
Yeah.
And so we shouldn't have to worry so much. Well, we'll do our best to not worry, but to expose.
Yeah.
There we go. Anyway, I want to start off with talking about the Inspector General for the Capitol Hill Police. They had to open up an investigation checking on the Capitol Hill Police themselves. There's rumors going on or evidence that's going on that something's going on with the staff. Spying on the members of Congress, but we know that Pelosi wouldn't do that except because she has this commission up. The commission she has to work on that nobody can touch is she has Republicans on there. Did you know that?
Yeah,
two Republicans on there.
Liz
Cheney. But she didn't fulfill the description of the committee that we set up. It was to be bipartisan, so they picked two people who had sworn allegiance to the Republican Party and allegiance to the Democrats. So she kicks off the Republicans that were appointed, and go on with them. And then they figure, well, at least they'll be decent and allow the information that's available the prosecution has, that is Pelosi has, that they would share it, with the people on the defense, the people they're charging with treason and all of the violence and insurrection. But guess what? She's filed a lawsuit to prevent them from ever looking at it.
Yeah.
So it's not a very American system of justice. So it's interesting. The Inspector General's looking into it. It's conceivable, you know, that he may be really serious into it. Time will tell. And but the one part that caught my attention, because we used to sit around in the office and kid, wonder where the microphones are, and always saying it in such a way that they couldn't possibly be doing that. But here's one headline: Capitol Police spies dressed like construction workers to surveil GOP congressman's office.
Yeah.
That's getting pretty bad. And I don't know if we can get to the bottom of this, but if there's a hint of this or evidence of this, everybody should have an obligation to do it, to do something about it. And I think this will be, just like Russiagate deserves to be involved in the next election. People say, just forget about it. It's all over and done with. Yes, but I don't think the principle is over and done with. You don't have to say, well, I'm going to be here until we put you away in prison for life. But boy, I think the American people deserve to know what's going on and the lies that they have proven. And there was a witch hunt going on back in over the 16 election, lasted for years. And now they're in another one, and that has to do with the 6th of January. And yet now, once again, there's evidence of shenanigans going on. So I think, from my viewpoint, which would be not a proven finality to it, I would say there was a lot of bad things happening in the last election, with the Hillary episode. And in here, very suspicious. It deserves examination. But I think we're not alone. I think the American people, more than a majority, are upset and they do not trust what their government says. Even here, I've already indicated, keep my fingers crossed, Let's hope we have some honest people here that will expose it. I believe they're still there, but it's a cost to them personally to, you know, speak out too much, just like that people go along with the wokeism because there are penalties, even though they don't believe in it.
And we reported on this earlier because it was a Politico article that talked about the Capitol Hill police were running background checks on people who were going to visit with their members of Congress or constituents, running background checks, and also searching social media accounts of any staffer who would be present at that meeting, which is clearly, clearly inappropriate and the illegal behavior on the part of the Capitol Hill police, who really are a Praetorian guard of the Speaker and the Senate Majority Leader. That's their own personal police force. So this new information, we can put up that first clip too. This is from the Federalist. This new information is that the Inspector General has opened an investigation into the allegations of spying on members of Congress and staff. And this includes a very peculiar accusation by Troy Nels, who is, I think he had part of your old district. He's from Texas. And he made a very, very serious, serious claim. And here, I'll just kind of give a nutshell as to what it is. And you can put on that second clip while I'm mentioning it. So apparently, the protocol is if a Capitol Hill cop sees a member's office open, they'll go in and look around them.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for tuning in to the Liberty Report. With us today is Daniel McAdams, our co-host. Daniel, good to have you with us today.
Good morning, Dr. Paul. How are you doing?
Doing well, doing well.
Sunny day? We're
back at the desk again, trying to sort out all falsehoods and the truths. And it's not the easiest thing in the world. You know, I keep thinking, well, why don't we just call the FBI and let them, maybe they'll help us. Oh, no, we have to investigate them, too.
Good morning, Dr. Paul. How are you doing?
Doing well, doing well. It's not the easiest thing in the world. You know, I keep thinking, well, why don't we just call the FBI and let them, maybe they'll help us. Oh, no, we have to investigate them, too. You
know? No good guys.
Well, if we can't trust the FBI, you surely could trust the CIA.
That's right.
And then if you couldn't trust them, how about a congressional investigation set up by Nancy Pelosi? They'll get to the bottom of it, and they're getting to the bottom of this January 6th incident. Yeah. And so we shouldn't have to worry so much. Well, we'll do our best to not worry, but to expose.
Yeah.
There we go. Anyway, I want to start off with talking about the Inspector General for the Capitol Hill Police. They had to open up an investigation checking on the Capitol Hill Police themselves. There's a room. It's not the easiest thing in the world. Yeah. You know, I keep thinking, well, why don't we just call the FBI and let them, maybe they'll help us. Oh, no, we have to investigate them, too. You
know? No good guys.
Well, if we can't trust the FBI, you surely could trust the CIA.
That's right.
And then if you couldn't trust them, how about a congressional investigation set up by Nancy Pelosi? They'll get to the bottom of it, and they're getting to the bottom of this January 6th incident.
Yeah.
And so we shouldn't have to worry so much. Well, we'll do our best to not worry, but to expose.
Yeah.
There we go. Anyway, I want to start off with talking about the Inspector General for the Capitol Hill Police. They had to open up an investigation checking on the Capitol Hill Police themselves. There's rumors going on or evidence that's going on that something's going on with the staff, spying on the members of Congress. But we know that Pelosi wouldn't do that except because she has this commission up. The commission she has to work on that nobody can touch is she has Republicans on there. Did you know that?
Yeah,
two Republicans on there.
Liz Cheney.
But she didn't fulfill the description of the committee that we set up. It was to be bipartisan. So they picked two people who have sworn allegiance to the Republican Party and allegiance to the Democrats. So she kicks off the Republicans that were appointed and then go on with them. And then they figure, well, at least they'll be decent and allow the information that's available. It's not the easiest thing in the world. You know, I keep thinking, well, why don't we just call the FBI and let them, maybe they'll help us. Oh, no,
I guess you got the point. That's the link in the description. Let's try that a little bit harder. Sorry, your chat is in the view. Everyone! Here, let's try that again. What's the name of that movie? I don't want to end this on a bang. Can't think of his name.
Here today, and you will tell of it later. All eyes to the front.
Now's a good time to fuck it.
Shut your fucking mouth! You must watch, dear. It'll all be over soon.
Corruption into our domain.
But if you do, one day you will look behind you and you will see we three. And on that day, you will rip it.
And we will send you to whatever God you wish.
We will send you to whatever God you wish.
And shepherds we shall be, for thee, my Lord, for thee. Power to send it forth from thy hand.
We
swiftly carry out thy command. So we shall flow ever forth to thee, and teeming with souls shall it ever be.
In nomine Patri,
et Filii, Spiritus Sancti.
Well, that made it to YouTube. Yeah, wipe your tear now. Because it used to be, it made you like cry. Now it made you. Grin. Which is a really hard thing to do. Why? What you doing? Being a dog? Well, you're a good dog. Get up. Make a little noise. Make sure that everyone online can hear you. Let's try this again. Everyone. Let's see what we get. Oh! Look at this. How amazing.
Is there a code, a way of knocking so he knows it's you? The team. Final position, we're ready to go.
Be careful.
I know the suspense. Be careful. Have you noticed? Do you want more? Yeah, you'll have to look it up. You'll have to look it up. I said it before, I'll say it again. I don't need the sword.